Today I am discussing about in this lecture what is volcanoes. That is, the topic is volcanoes. First of all, when I am saying about volcanoes, therefore the question in on your mind is, what is volcano? You see in picture, this is the volcano eruption. A volcano is a vent or chimney, okay, which transfers molten rock known as magma from depth of to the earth surface. Magma erupting from volcanoes is called lava, and is the material which builds up the cone surrounded the vent. You see in picture, the volcanoes is a eruption. A broad type of the eruption of the volcanoes. Now, due to volcano, when why volcanoes are created? When a earthquake occurs, or any atomic bomb blast, nuclear power plants in goes to blast, and tectonic plates rub over each other, then the magma is outcome from the earth surface, where this that point the earth surface is found a weak, then the volcanoes, this types of phenomena is called volcanoes blast. Okay, volcanoes can cause widespread destruction and consequent disasters in several ways. The effects include the volcanic eruption itself, that may cause harm following the explosion of the explosion of the volcano, or the fall of rocks, some ashes from the volcanoes. Second, lava may be produced during the volcano eruption. That is, the as it leaves the the volcanoes, the lava destroys me building and plants it encounters. And third one is the volcanic ash, generally meaning the cooled ash. It is very cool condition. Therefore, many form a cloud and settle thickly in nearby locations. When mixed with water, this forms a concrete like material in sufficient quantity, as may cause roots and to collapse under the weights, but even small quantities will harm humans if inhaled, since the ash has the consistency of group glass. It causes abrasion damage to the moving parts such as engines. The main killer of humans in the immediate surroundings of volcanic eruption is the pyroclastic flows, which consist of a cloud of hot volcanic ash which builds up the air above the volcano and rushes down the slopes. When the eruptions no longer supports, the lifting of the gases, it is believed the Pompeii was destroyed by the pyroclastic flows. This is called a lahar, a volcanic mud flow of landslides. as well as in Tangwai disasters in 1953, was caused very peoples are going to death, and very the environmental biological diversity is goes to be collapsed. When a volcanoes is active, because the seismic activities, tectonic plates movement, therefore the gas and lava releasing initially. Okay. Once a volcano has been dormant for more than 10,000 years, it is termed extinct. Okay. The explosiveness of a volcanic eruption depends on how easily magma can flow and the amount of gas trapped within the magma between the earth surface, sandwiched in the earth surface, and a large amount of water and carbon dioxide are dissolved in magma, causing it to behave in a similar way to gas expanding in Fiji drinks, which forms bubbles and escapes from openings. Okay. The forms of volcano provides a clue to the type and size of its eruption, which is controlled by the characteristics and composition of magma. Okay. Now the size, style and frequency of eruption can be differ greatly, very differences, but all these elements correlates the all types of elements, shape of the volcanoes. There are here in three types of common volcanoes are here. First one is the sealed type volcanoes. These types here, first one is the sealed type volcanoes, and second one is the composite volcanoes, that is the called strato, and the third one is the caldera volcano. Now therefore, sealed volcano. When magma is very hot and runny, gas mixes in gases can escape and comes from the earth surface, then this eruptions are generated very fastly with considerable amount. It is very hot in condition, therefore the magma reaching on the surface and goes to after some time, it is a condensed and formation of cloudy seasons, like a shape created by layers, runny lava on the earth surface. Okay. Now the lava flows are sufficient slow. The lava can flow are sufficiently slow for humans to overturn or outwalk the surface of the magma erupted by the volcanoes, because the temperature of volcanoes is 800 to 1200 degrees centigrade of the temperature on that type of magma erupted by the volcanoes. Now next one is the composite volcano, that is called Sterlo, also known as Sterlo volcanoes. These volcanoes are characterized by an explosive eruptions style. This is blast, boom. When magma is slightly cooler, it is the thick and sticky or viscous material liquid, which makes it harder for gas bubbles to expand and escape. The resulting pressure causes the magma to form foam and explode while blasting it into teeny pieces known as volcanic ash. These eruptions creates step sides, cones. They can also create lava flows, hot ashes, cloud called pyroclastic flows, and dangerous mud flows called lahars. And this type of magma has a temperature between 800 and 1100 degrees centigrade. It's called andestic magma. This types of magma are called andestic magma. Next one is the caldera volcano. They erupt so explosively that little material builds up near the vent. This is the vent. The resulting basin shaped depression is roughly circular and is usually several kilometers or more in diameters. The lava erupt from caldera volcanoes is very viscous and generally the coolest, with temperature reaching from 650 degrees centigrade to 800 degrees centigrade, and is called rhyolitic magma. Although caldera volcanoes are rare, it is not found frequently in any region. It is rare found in any particular that regions. It is most dangerous. Volcanic hazards from this type of eruption include widespread ash fall, large pyroclastic surges, and tsunamis for caldera collapse into oceans. Now the next one is the several we can discuss in here the several types of volcanic eruptions. The types of volcanic eruptions during which lava tephra as lapilli, volcanic bumps and blocks, and assorted gases are expelled from a volcanic vent or fissures. Our fissures have been distinguished by volcanologists. These are often named after famous volcanoes where that type of behavior has been observed. Some volcanoes may be exhibit only one characteristic type of eruption during a period of activity, while others may display an entire sequence of types and all in one eruptive series, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 interconnected to each other like that. You see in picture volcanoes have two branches, secondary cone and crater, that is the first cone. So that is in the series formation. There are three different types of eruptions, that is the magmatic eruptions and ferrometric eruptions, ferritic eruptions, super heating types of steam via contact with magma. And these eruptive types of events magmatic release, instead causing the granulation of existing rocks. Within these type of volcanoes, the weakest are Hawaiian and submarine. And storm baleen followed by volcanic and sustains stronger eruptive types of PLN eruptions. PLN eruptions. That is the volcanic explosivity index. That is the VEI to calculate the strength of the volcanoes. In order to magnitude scale ranging from 0 to 8, that often correlates to eruptive types. 0, very least eruption, 5, moderate, and 8 is it is high eruptive types of volcanoes. Okay, that is the what are the main features of a volcano you see in picture clearly. That type of picture, this is the magma chamber situated in below the earth surface. This is the magma chamber. We can see the earth, this is the earth surface. When the volcano is formed, the earth surface is very weak at that point. Here, 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 they are not weak, but in that point the volcano is found a very weak earth surface. Therefore, it is going to a blast. That is the that are called volcanic eruption or volcano blasting condition. Therefore, we can see a formation of a crater. Previously, it is float at that point. That is, this is, and condensed, and they can solidify and formation a rock. And then the magma is up to goes to the rise and solidify, and then formation that types of solid, that is the mountainous type of craters. Therefore, crater formations, that this is the crater. Firstly, the main chamber, main canals, main pipes formation by the magma to called a main crater. This is the crater, and float the lava are called lava flowing. This is the main vent, and secondary cone formation. The intensity and the pressure of the magma flowing eruption, magma eruptions by the volcanoes is very high. Therefore, the secondary cone is formulated and the lava and ashes to float that point. Okay. Here, firstly, we see the lava and ashes. Firstly, the when first of all, initially the volcano eruption, therefore the first of all a volcanoes have produces some ashes and lava initially. Okay, and you see in picture white and blackish form. This is the ashes and mixture of lava, but red color represents this is the hot molten magma which have temperature is approximately 1000 degree, 800 to 1000 degree centigrade. Okay, now next point is what causes volcanoes. You see in picture volcanoes on earth from rising magma. Magma rises in three different places. First one is the hot spot volcanoes. Second one is the underwater volcanoes in sea or in under covered water surface. And third one present here, you can see in volcanoes from melted crust, where the earth crust is goes to melt, then the magma flows to the that point. Okay, Now volcanoes occurs when material significantly warmer than the warmer than its surroundings is erupted onto a surface of a planet or moon from its interior. On Earth, the erupted material can be liquid rock that are called lava. When it's on the surface, that is called magma. Okay. When it's underground, then they are called lava, and it can from surface, then they are called magma. As cinders and gases, there are three reasons why magma might rises and causes eruptions onto our surface. We can discuss in that picture and explain here. Magma rises when the piece of earth crust called tectonic plates, like tectonic plates, where two tectonic plates are connected to each other. The tectonic plates slowly moves away from each other and come from each other. When the tectonic plates moves away from each other, therefore the magma rises up to fill in the space of this tectonic plates, this gap of the tectonic plates. When this happens under water volcanoes, can from magma also rises when these tectonic plates moves towards each other and fill the molten magma, and therefore the it goes to blast and solidify and formation a mountain or rock formation in between in a sea level. The high heat and pressure cause the crust to melt. When the pressure and the heat goes to very high temperature and pressure, therefore the earth crust goes to melt. A final way that magma rises is over hot spots. These hot spots are exactly what they should like, hot areas inside of earth. These areas heat up magma. The magma becomes less dense when it is less dense. It rises and this formation are called the series of production eruptions of the magmas. Now next one is the previously it can be discussed, but here we can also discuss types of volcanoes. Three types of volcanoes we can understand, we can study in previous slides. That is the three types of volcanoes. Number one, classical cones are stratovolcanoes. Second one, volcanic fields. And third one, calderas and collapse craters. It is very dangerous conditions. We all are known about in above slides. This is one type, but some of the most explosive volcanoes are less obvious and represented by large depression that may be filled with water and so on. In New Zealand, active volcanoes look quite different from one another. They can be grouped into following categories and so on. Each of these has distinct landforms and the volcanic valence and style of eruptions are unique to each. These differences reflect the main type of magma erupted. Like andesites at the cone volcanoes, basalts and rhyolite at calderas. Okay, now next one is the How is the volcano formed? Okay. So now firstly we can conclude one, we can explain that the disturbance created in earth crust, then therefore the hot molten lava rises up to the earth surface, and this they are called magma. By the distributed all over the world in different countries, and countries but are not found into a very country. Okay, the volcanoes found in some countries is very large amount of numbers, but in some country the volcanoes is found least number. Okay, now the volcanoes prone areas, that is the ring of fire, where the prone area, their ring formation, a round of Pacific plates across the north and south, a Atlantic Ocean, there are still anomalies, hot spots. The earthquake is a major condition to create, to active the volcanoes. Okay, in volcanoes and earthquakes are both formed on plate boundaries. However, there is a difference between the two, since volcanoes are never formed on conservative and divergent boundaries, because there is no change in crust to allow more magma, molten rock to be made. Okay. Now next one is the glowing magma of earth mantle. To the surface of the earth, and searching for way to escape through cracks in earth's crust. Therefore, a volcano is born, where volcanoes is created. This erupt magma into the air in the form of molten gas, ash and solid fragments. Therefore, the eruption of magma, eruption of the volcanoes is very harmful effects, and our environment, our atmosphere, because a volcano affects people in many some and are good conditions, because the ash flow on the crater of the volcanoes, and ash fall is float on and in our environments. That is the 100 to 200 kilometer per hour speeds of that type of ashes, and the gases, also gases are created, gases are flowed for that crater of volcanoes. That is the water vapor, the most common gas released by volcanoes, causes few problems. Sulfur dioxide, carbon dioxide and hydrogen are released in smaller amounts. Carbon monoxide, hydrogen sulfide and hydrogen fluoride are also released, but typically less than 1% by volume of gases. Okay. The continuous eruption of the volcanoes goes to a present problem, that is the long term exposure to volcanic fumes may aggravate existing respiratory problems. It different problem created in our environments, that is the aircraft do not move our aircrafts in that type of locations to whole country affected, some part of globe affected by the this types of SS. To put it mildly, S is bad for jet aircraft engines. Apparently the problem is much more severe for modern jet engines, which burn hotter than the older ones. Okay. Parts of these engines operate at temperature that are high enough to melt S, that is ingested. Therefore, the lava inside the engine, and the engine goes to rises, the temperature of the engine is very high, and forced back part is the temperature is goes to the very lower. Therefore, stuff solidify the engines, and you can imagine that dumping a whole bunch of abrasive powder into a jet engine is not a jet engine is not a good for the engine. This has been a pretty non-scientific explanation of the problem. I just found an article that describes the problem a little more technically, but here simply we can explain here. Now next one is the city and towns. The city and towns is affected very badly. Okay. Because the effect and eruption will have on a nearby city could vary from none at all to catastrophic trophy. For example, atmospheric conditions and carry away from the topographic might direct lahar and pyroclastic flows to unpolluted, areas, and the context of the person in that particular atmospheric, that is here where the eruption of the volcanoes. These conditions all are lahars, pyroclastic flows, and are as falls could enter the city, causing death and destructions many times. Okay. The point out that is most volcanic crisis, geologists advise local civil defenses authorities. The civil defense authorities decide what to do concerning evacuation, that is present here. Now, okay, how are safe volcanoes in our mind? Next question is rises here. How safe are volcanoes? Okay. Therefore, we can say volcanoes are much safer than other natural events such as earthquakes, flood, and hurricanes. However, volcanic eruptions can hurl hot rocks for at least 30 kilometer flood. Airborneness or noxious fumes can spread 160 kilometer or more area. If you live or work near is known as volcano active or dormant, and we can ready to move for this place and stay out of that area. And a lateral blast of a volcano can travel many kilometer from the mountain. Okay. Therefore, the type trying to watch and erupting volcano is a deadly idea. Okay. That is the jaan jokhim mein dalna in a Hindi term. Be prepared for these disasters that can be spawned by volcano, earthquake, flash flood, landslides, and mud flows, thunderstorms, tsunamis, and evacuations. That is the rock debris from a volcano can break and window and set building on fire, lava, the area before the disasters begins. It is the initial conditions. Safety performance when visiting an active volcanoes. First one is the pre-planning. Pre-planning have read about past eruptions. These types of volcanoes are the characteristics in which situation these types of volcanoes are active in active conditions, goes to in active conditions. This past history is also we can study, and then you can go read about eruptions of the visiting of the volcanoes. Okay, what the volcano has done in the past is what is it is capable of doing in the future. While volcano are inherently unpredictable, studies of past eruption at a particular volcano will give any indication of what is possible, what possible conditions. Therefore, we can say that the which situations the our volcanoes is goes to active conditions. Okay, now read about past accidents. It is very important in the volcano studies or visiting the volcanoes. That is the read about past accidents, analyze what went wrong in past accidents, the bulletin of the global volcanism, that is the news, that is the record any systems of the volcano eruptions. Volcanoes network, that is the Smithsonian Institute has the best monthly volcanic activity reports, including accident reports and many things about characteristics of the volcanoes, day to day varies, many things. Now, two accidents have happened on field trips associated with International Volcanology Conference, Galeras in 1993 and Semeru 2000. Two accidents were found in that time, when the site visits of the volcanoes. Many scientists are inexperienced when it comes to climbing volcanoes. Theoretical knowledge is no replacement for field experience. Field experience is more important than the theoretical knowledge. Theoretical knowledge is not support to the field. Field conditions is the different situations, and in theoretical situation is another situations. Field situations is that is a it can be understand by that the you can go on a road by vehicle, therefore you can you are not know about any animals come on the road at any time. Therefore, the experience you have experience driving the vehicle, therefore you go to fast moving the fast vehicle moves to fast vehicle in a blank road, clean road, but our experience is supported to we are run on the road is controlled conditions, because you can run on a flat road, you can go fast, and you can, you are going, you are passing through any city, any forest, any other situations, then you can go simple, smaller speeds, lesser speed with comparison to the flat or blank road. Now this is the experienced oriented conditions. Now next one is the observe the volcano for at least 24 hours before getting close to the danger zone. Okay, you can stay on the nearer of the volcanoes to observe 24 hours. You can, you are observing, and then you go back the danger zone. That is the record the number of explosions per hour, hourly the explosions occur, and know what the volcano is doing. It is a natural process because it can, it have a fluidity property. Fluid, we don't know flow, fluid to flow in directions where the fluid are found a path, then the fluid goes that path, follow that path. Therefore sometimes a 2 to 3 day observation period is required before approaching the summit areas and the nearer danger zone. Simply arriving at the volcano and climbing straight to the summit is asking for trouble. Know the current volcano warning level. That is the know the current volcano warning level, and we can discuss in next lecture. This is not completed in this lecture. Okay, thank you.